Hello, welcome to Dulcet, and in this video we are going to unbox the DC-F30X single din MP3 car stereo from Dulcet. So just stay tuned and watch till the end. So this is how the box of DC-F30X looks like, right? So now just let's open it from here and just see what we get inside the box. First, there's the packet for all the things which comes with the stereo, and here's the main stereo. So we'll be discussing each one of them in detail. So let's just start with the things that comes with the box. The first thing that comes with the box is the user manual, which has all the details for the wirings, the function of the car stereo, what are the features of the car stereo, and also it tells you how the remote control functions, what are the function of each and every button on the remote. The product instructions are detailedly there, the product guidelines and installation instructions are also mentioned in the manual. So it's a very in-depth manual. So once you get the car stereo, you won't have any problem in terms of installing or knowing about any other feature. You can find everything out in the manual itself. Then you get a small thank you card from our side, which has all the details on how you can contact us, our customer support number, and a letter of thank you from our side for ordering our product. And then you get this particular remote, which looks very stylish and sleek, and it has all the buttons. If you can see, it comes with volume control, the mute option, menu option, the options to set like the forward, backward, up and down in terms of folders, AMS, and then power buttons, and you can control every single thing of the car stereo from the remote itself. And you can even take and disconnect calls from the car stereo itself, from the remote itself, once your phone is connected with the Bluetooth. So it comes in really handy, and it makes it possible for you to operate your car stereo even from the back seat. So it's a really big convenience feature that comes with DC-F30X. And then you get the power cables. This is how the power cables look like. And then again, you get a cable for the speakers. The car stereo supports four speakers, two for the front speakers and two at the back. So you can connect four speakers to the car stereo. And then you also get a 3.5mm aux cable to just make sure that you can enjoy the music from your phone directly with the help of an aux cable. And you need not to get any additional aux cable from the market, as we provide the same in the box itself. And the last thing that you get with the stereo is the removal key. This will help you in uninstalling your existing car stereo and applying the new DC-F30X car stereo in your car, right? So now let's just move on to the main car stereo head unit. So this is how it looks like. I will be even turning it on later in this video. So, but before that, I would like to show like how it looks like once it's not turned on. So let's just discuss each feature of the car stereo in detail. The first button that you can see, it's a mode button with power and call disconnecting. This button functions as three multiple buttons. First, if you long press this particular button, it will turn on the car stereo or turn it off. And if you short press, it will be working as a mode button to change the different modes like aux, USB and all that stuff. And in case your phone is connected with the Bluetooth and a call comes, this button acts as a helps you in cutting down the call. And the button which is below, which will help you in picking up the call, and also functions as a band button. The button in the center is the reverse button. You can skip to the previous track or previous FM station from this particular thing. And then in the center you have the volume knob, which is a multifunctional volume knob. It helps you in adjusting volume, bass, treble, equalizer settings, loudness on and off. I will be showing in the later stages in the video once it's turned on, like how it functions. And then it's a mute button, and then there's a forward button, and below that there's a clock button, which will show you the timing, what is going on right now. And then you get these buttons like with the pause and 1, 2, repeat, RMD, plus 5, plus 10. This is for like specifically if your pen drive has a lot of songs and you want to skip to a particular song, you can do it with the help of that. So we have discussed all the buttons. Now let's look up to the connectivity features. The first connectivity features you get is under the volume knob. You get an SD card slot input, which will help you in like attaching your memory card from the phone and directly listening to the music from the memory card. And then you can see a mic over here. This is specifically when you are like connected with the Bluetooth and you want to talk from the car stereo itself on any call, you want to attend a call. You can take those calls and your voice will be transmitted to this particular mic, right? And then you get an LCD display. And after that, you get two USB sockets in this particular car stereo. The first one is for playing songs from the USB and the second one is for charging, right? But in case you are not using the USB pen drive and maybe playing songs by Bluetooth or an aux, you can plug in two charging cables at the same time, and the passenger as well as the co-passenger can charge the phone together at the same time, right? Just below that, you get an aux input where you can just connect your aux and play the songs, as we have already given an aux cable. So just look at this particular the cabinet of the product. It's really well built, and so it makes it really very durable. At the back side, if you move down, you will get, first of all, you get an antenna socket for connecting to the antenna for the FM radio, and then you get the RCA jack output for connecting it to amplifiers, bass tube, or any other audio source. And then after, you get the power socket and the space for the cables of the speakers, right? As shown earlier in the video, in the downside one, you can connect the power cables, and in the upside, you can connect the speaker cables. And then you also get a fuse, if you can see this. So this helps you in the case of like, if there's something wrong with the wiring or there is some misconnections over there. So that will prevent the short circuit and prevent the stereo from getting damaged. The entire shock or everything will be bare by the fuse, and the fuse will get diffused, right? So it makes it really very durable, this particular car stereo. And this is a small thing that which helps in like installation of the car stereo. So now let's just turn it on and see like how it looks like. So if you see, you just click it once and it turns on, and you can see it looks absolutely amazing once it's turned on, right? So now let's talk. I have told you about each and every feature earlier only, but if you see, like if you long press it turns it off. If you once it short presses, it changes the mode, right? Aux, Bluetooth, and then it changes the modes. And then you can even like previous, forward. And this particular volume knob we were talking about, this is the volume knob, this is how it functions. If you just press it once, if you see this, if you just do it like this, it will be starting controlling the volume up and down. And once you once click it, it's bass, and then it adjusts the treble, and one more click, it adjusts the balance right and left, and then it comes to the fader. For those of you who don't know what fader is, fader is an effect which helps you in controlling the front and the back speakers. So just in case the back passengers don't want to listen to the music and you want to listen to the music as a driver, you can turn off the back speakers and turn the front speakers on, right? Only the front speaker will be functioning with the help of fader, or you can do vice versa also. And then going beyond, there's an EQ function which supports like all the EQ functions like classic, pop, rock, and all the flat things are there, and you can even turn it off. And then you move down to, there's a feature for loudness on and off. And at last, you also get a feature for stereo and mono functions, right? Where you can adjust this, the settings to stereo or mono. And then there's a mute button which will mute the entire system, whatever which is going on. The next button we have already talked about. And then there's a clock function which will show you the timing, right? And these all buttons we have already given a brief about. And the best thing about this particular car stereo is that it's a universal fit car stereo. So no matter whichever size you have, the slot size, every car comes with a universal fit slot size. So this car stereo fits in all cars which all have the universal slot size. But for even for your reference, we will attach the sizes, the exact dimension of the car stereo, so that you don't have any issue in terms of the installation. And as you can see, this covers the entire thing, like whatever entertainment needs you have in a car, in a very compact way. This particular car stereo covers all of it, right? And if you would like to order this car stereo for your own car, you can get it from any online store like Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, Paytm all. But if you're looking forward to get an additional discount on our products, you can head towards like dulcetelectronics.in, which is our official website, where you can find this product and many other products also. And there's a coupon code which will be given in the description below. So that's it from my side. And if you like the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And also don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon if you want to stay updated with such videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching.